Hello friends, in this video lecture, let us solve a numerical on change in frequency. So let us begin. So friends, till now, we have discussed the concept regarding the load frequency control for single area concept. Okay, now we are going to solve some numerical related to the change in frequency. Okay, here the question is given: a 100 MVA synchronous generator operates on full load at a frequency 50 Hz. So this 50 Hz frequency, it is a full load frequency. Okay, now it is said that the load is suddenly reduced to 50 megawatt. Okay, now due to the time lag in the governor system, the steam valve begin to close in 0.4 second. See, we know that when the load decreases, speed increases. So in order to control the speed, we need to close the gate. Okay, or we need to reduce the steam input to the turbine. So that is what the governor do here. The valve begin to close, but definitely it will take some time. Okay, that is the time constant of the speed governor. We have considered this time constant as well while discussing the dynamic response. Okay, the same time constant we have taken. Determine the change in frequency that occurs in this time. Okay, in this 0.4 second, what will be the change in the frequency? Because there is a time delay is there. So because of this, definitely the frequency will change. Okay, and it will increase because the load is decreasing now. So definitely frequency will increase. And of course here that inertia constant is given for the generator. It is given as 5 kilowatt second for each KVA. Okay, so let us discuss now solution. Okay, see, we know that the kinetic energy is been stored in the rotating part of the generator of the turbine. Okay, KE stored in the rotating part of generator. Okay, generator and turbine, we can say. Okay, how we can calculate that kinetic energy? That also we have discussed. KE, we indicated as WKE. Okay. Okay, let us now do it for scheduled frequency or the full load frequency. So as we are doing for the scheduled frequency, we'll put here 0. Okay, so it will be, see, H value is given. It is nothing but H into PR. That is, PR is nothing but the KW rating of the generator. Okay, so with that, this will become, H is nothing but 5. And the KW rating, it is given 100 MVA. So 100 into MVA, but we need here per KVA. Okay, we need this value per KVA. So I'll bring this in. We'll multiply this with 1000 to convert this into the KVA. Okay, so if you solve this, you'll get it the value of the kinetic energy stored in the rotating part of the generator or the turbine at the full load. It will be 5 into 10 to the power 5. Kilowatt second. Okay, so this is the kinetic energy which is stored in the rotating part of the generator or the turbine at the full load value. Okay, now as the load is decreased, definitely in this time period the input is now increasing. Okay, as the load is changing in this time period, 0.4 second, some more amount of kinetic energy will be stored, because we know that that equation, do you remember that delta Pg minus delta Pd, that is the incremental input to the generator load model. Okay, as the load is decreasing, so we get here some net surplus power, and that net surplus power, we consider it into two parts. One is the kinetic energy storing, and the another one is by increasing the generation. Okay, So here, by increasing or decreasing the generation, and that way we can utilize the net surplus power, okay, or else we can reduce the load as well, reduce or increase or decrease the load as well. But here let us consider that this net surplus power, whatever we are getting here, let us utilize it to convert it to the in a kinetic energy, okay. So that too, the gate closing operation is beginning after 0.4 second. Of course, after 0.4 second we will not have that net surplus power because the gates will be closed. We get that net surplus power only for 0.4 second. So we have to calculate the amount of kinetic energy which is stored in that 0.4 second only. Okay, so let us calculate the KE stored in 0.4 second. Okay, in the rotating part, of course. So that is nothing but 50 megawatt is the reduction in the load. Okay, this is nothing but load reduction. Okay, because now I want KE, kinetic energy, at some other frequency, because frequency has changed. So WKE, I want this. We can calculate again H into PR. Okay, of course we have calculating it for some time, so we will take that time as well, seconds. Okay, so that 5 into, now the load is changed now. Okay, so instead of taking full load, so we'll write here 50 into 1000 into 0.4. okay, if you solve this, you will get the value as 20,000 kilowatt second. Okay, so we got that kinetic energy at some other frequency. Okay, now we know that the kinetic energy is in direct proportion to the frequency square. So from this, can we write frequency is in direct proportion to square root of the kinetic energy? Of course we can write it is in direct proportion to the square root of the kinetic energy. Okay, so now with this I can write the new frequency. This is F naught is the full load frequency or scheduled frequency, and let this F be the new frequency or changed frequency. Okay, so from this we can write, of course, this F will be proportional to WKE. Okay, and this F naught will be proportional to the square root of WKE naught. Okay, so from this, if I relate this, because both are in proportional, so we can get here F is equal to, see, F is equal to, we can make directly square root, and F naught is equal to this. So we'll bring this two terms in proportion. So what we will get if I write in proportional, and I'll omit this proportionality with, I'll replace this proportionality with is equal to sign. So we get here F, that is the new frequency, divided by F naught. Here you get square root of change in frequency or the new kinetic energy divided by kinetic energy at F naught. Okay, now here F, we want the change in frequency or the new frequency. First let us calculate, then we can calculate the change in frequency. F is equal to, put a shift this F naught that side. Okay, now this kinetic energy at the changed frequency or the new frequency, so definitely it will be that 5 to the power 10 to the power 5. So it is 5 5 times 0 plus that 20,000 divided by kinetic energy at scheduled frequencies. Again it is 5 to the power 5 into 10 to the power 5, so it will be 500 bracket power 1/2. Okay, 1/2 because it is square root. And now of course this F naught is 50 hertz. Okay, if you solve this, you'll get F is equal to 50.99 hertz. That is the new frequency. Let us assume it to be approximately equal to 51 hertz. So what is the change in frequency in the time 0.4 second? So we can say that the change in frequency would be 51 minus 50, that is 1 hertz. So that is the change in frequency which is going to occur in the time period, that is 0.4 second. The frequency will go up by 1 hertz. Okay. So this is how we have to solve the numerical related to the change in frequency. Okay. Thank you very much.